Decision tree analysis. It's another quantitative risk assessment technique where we use probability and impact to understand what kind of decision should be taken for achieving the project objective. This particular technique helps us in visualizing the nesting of decision. Like I take a decision one and outcome one comes, outcome two comes, and if outcome one comes and if I take another decision on outcome one, then what could be the outcome three and outcome four? So we can go in a tree mode where each node could be a decision point and branches are showing as a possible outcome, outcome one and outcome two. In the PMP exam, we are not expected to perform decision tree analysis. You understand that it's a quantitative risk assessment tool, which is a little complicated and it uses probability and impact. So for example, I may want to understand, oh, should I do PMP or should I not do PMP? That kind of a decision I'm making. And then I also want to see if I do PMP and the job market is positive, then probably I will get this much benefit. And if I do PMP and job market is not positive, then I will be having this impact. The second thing is I'm not doing PMP, and even if then job market is positive, this is a possible outcome I can make. And if I'm not doing PMP and the job market is poor, these are the possible outcome I can have. So I have a four situations now based which can help me in making a decision. Is it good to invest my time and energy for doing the PMP? So that kind of probabilistic analysis. Now you understand that there are probability of job market going high, job market going low, and doing PMP, not doing PMP. And by plotting this particular diagram, it can help you in making appropriate decision. But for PMP exam, do not worry about plotting the decision tree, but you understand it's a technique which is a quantitative risk assessment technique.